Hey, my name is Replay and welcome along to another episode of the Minecraft High Tech series. And this one actually took a long while to get out because you have been spamming me on Discord, on Facebook, on Instagram that I don't even have, on whatever, YouTube even. Please, you said, make a tutorial on the Mumbo Jumbo 5x5 door. You've been begging me and oh boy, I can tell you, I did a tutorial and I didn't press record. So, oh boy, I did another tutorial and the audio fucked up. So, heck yeah, I'm gonna do it the third time and please let it work. That's all I want. Anyway, without further ado, I guess we should just start because it's gonna be quite a long tutorial. Okay, we can start with a base platform that's 5x13. This will be our front. And there we place a dropper right here in the middle. The door will be raised 3 blocks from the ground. And this will be our main block where the door is standing on. So, we place a redstone lamp right here. An observer going down, over, and 2 more across. From the dropper, 3 more observers and 1 to the back, 1 back up, and we place 3 sticky pistons in the middle, 1 on the redstone lamp and 1 normal piston on the observer. We go with another observer like this, 1 here, here and here. We place a yellow wool block right here with a repeater on top with 4 ticks delay. Observer facing upwards, a redstone block on this side. 2 more yellow wool blocks right here and repeaters here and here. If you have difficulties placing that one, either place it on the wool block or press shift to click onto that dropper. We use redstone dust to connect these bits together and we can cover up everything already with white concrete in my case, one here and like so. This one is important because we will push it back up, because it's basically a 2x1 hipster door. We can place an end rod on top of here, white concrete to cover up the front, and that is the main floor, basically. Now we do the next side, which will be the exact same, just flipped over. We place 3 wool blocks like this, with redstone torches on top, a slab right here with a redstone dust on top of that, redstone lamp, observer just like so, another dropper, 3 more observers, you get a drill, 2 more across and 2 more just like so. You place another piston downwards and another upwards facing right next to the other piston. Then we need 3 more sticky pistons, just like this. We need 1 more observer right here, and 3 more again, like this. Now we grab ourselves a lever to deactivate everything. It's gonna make a mess, but that's no problem. We just repair everything really neatly. And now we take ourselves some yellow glass blocks. You can use any transparent block, you don't have to use yellow glass or whatever, you can for example use glowstone even. Then we use white concrete, place it right here and cover everything up just like this again. Keep the center hole for the end rod. And now we need to place redstone dust right here. And we're gonna grab ourselves some slabs, put them like so and... I wanna go home. I am at home, but that makes no difference. And we take a hopper, go from the back right here. We use a trap chest, place it here. Now we can redirect the redstone dust just like so. We place another repeater on 4 ticks in that direction. And that should do the trick for this side already. If you press the lever, perfect. It should retract without problems. Now we can focus on the bottom half as well. We can use slabs like this, another repeater on top with a redstone dust and a torch on the side. It should deactivate deliver just to have everything fixed, and it should retract both just neatly. It didn't do so, but that's no issue, we can fix that later. I'm just gonna copy over the other side now. Okay, now before I activate the door again, we have to make sure to not forget about something really important, because we have to place a note block right in that corner to fix the breaking of the bottom circuit. If you flick the lever now, everything should just look like this, working perfectly fine, and if you flick it again, everything should retract without any issues. Perfect! Now we can focus on the green circuit. And for that, we take a stone slab right here, a block next to it, and one diagonal with three more stone slabs going across into another block. We use redstone torches to hook everything up, and redstone dust, just like so. We can place white concrete as a T formation right here, and we go across with another green wool block right here and a slab right here. We use powered rails to hook those up together. Observer to the side, with another one going below and another one across. We can exchange this observer with a repeater on 4 ticks, another observer on top with a wool block. One more observer going to the back. Now we take ourselves some trapdoors, place it right here, three more observers on top with a normal piston facing this way. Two sticky pistons right here, and another one right here. Then we use another observer, place it on the bottom sticky piston facing upwards, another sticky piston right on front, and we take ourselves some slime blocks right here, here and here, and we can cover everything up already with white concrete, one here that's going to be the cover for the closed section, another one here, here, here and here. Then we take shulker boxes. In my case, you can move any unmovable block. Place it here and here. And some more right here. Let's cover up those two gaps. And I'm gonna copy it over again. Okay, now if we flick the lever, we should see everything working just fine. Perfect. And the retraction. Excellent. So to start the blue circuit, we go on top like this. Build just the first layer. Then we go all the way over to the other side. Break those two. Go here as well. And we can place three blocks like this and delete that one. We should have a shape like this now. From there we can place the slime blocks in a C shape up on top right here. We delete those three and place them here again. Place another concrete here and here. And then use an end rod to place it right down here, facing it downwards. Now we need sticky pistons to hook those up, placing them downwards like this, and cover the blocks back up. Should look pretty similar to this now. Then we can use observers, place them on top of the redstone dust, just like so, and on the other side as well. Now we use sticky pistons, placing one downwards right here, and one facing upwards with another slime block attached to it, and two more like this. Another sticky piston downwards, and this will be our main flying machine. Then we can place an observer here and here for the activation, and for the deactivation on this side. Another one on top facing to the front, and a blue wool right here Now we need to block off the flying machine to prevent it from moving accidentally. We do that with placing an obsidian down here or just any unmovable block. And we could do the same on top right here, but since it's gonna look pretty ugly to have just this one single block sticking out, I'm gonna do it with a barrier block, which is also unmovable. And you can, if you build it into structure, you can just hit the build limit or the push limit of the piston with many more blocks here. Now we use observers, place them here and here facing downwards. Another obsidian block right here with redstone dust on top. We need a slab right here with a rail on top. An observer going this way and down and over. From there we use more wool blocks, placing them here, here, here and here, like a W shape. Then three more on top, just like so. Another observer facing to the front like this and connecting it over like so. Two more pieces of redstone dust, actually one more piece of redstone dust right here, a repeater on one tick facing to the left side and another one on four ticks. On the top we go with redstone dust all across, and that's basically all of the front done. Now we need to hide those blocks down here, which is with placing a sticky piston here and a normal piston right here. From there we go with a node block here with an observer facing this way. On top we put a repeater on four ticks with a redstone dust and blue wool here. And we do the same thing on the other side. It should look pretty similar to this now. Now we need the middle section, which is a bit more tricky than that, because we need to push the end rod away, exchange it with a normal piston and push it back into place. We do that basically the same way. It's tricky to place this now. We need to break that one to place a normal piston facing downwards. We can replace that one. And we need another normal piston facing this way. And that should be everything done already. To try the flying machine to see if it all works properly, you have to break this obsidian block and pop up the bottom section first, because this one will be our stopping point. And then we produce a normal block here and here. The flying machine should be sent off and it should look like this. To retract everything again, we place a block onto this observer. We can break that again and it should stop just in place. And if we retract everything at the bottom, we should see on the top everything is fully flush. Now we can use the shulker boxes again to fill out the gaps. We can use any unmovable block again. And the blue circuit is basically done already. And now to hook up the bottom section and the top section together, we need two circuits, one falling edge and rising edge. The first one, we place a piston right here, a sticky piston, with an observer facing upwards into a normal piston with glass on the side. You can not use normal blocks here, you have to use transparent blocks all the way up to the chest height. Then we go with a normal block. Now we go with the observer into a normal block, just like this. And stone slab on this side. It should look like this now. You place a normal piston facing downwards and redstone dust all across. From there we go again with the obsidian blocking off the flying machine, because we will go for the triggering system now. We use slabs, go all the way over and place redstone dust on top of that. From there we go with
another pink wool block to block off the connection. You place another observer here, up on top, and back over to have both of the observers powered in the right way. At the end, we place an observer facing this way with two slabs attached to it on the side, with one more wool block into a hopper with a slab on top. We connect all of this with redstone dust on top, and this side is done. For the other side, it's pretty similar, but not exactly the same. We use a sticky piston down on this side with an observer facing outwards into a magenta block with a piston on top. We use butt switching or quasi connectivity to hook those two up together. For that, we need a node block right here. And from there, we go with magenta glass all the way up to the chest again. We keep in mind to use transparent blocks because this observer will trigger the other pistons. We don't want that. So continuing, we use another observer facing upwards, magenta wool, just like on the other side, with a slab on this side, normal piston facing downwards, and hook it all up with redstone again. Should look like this. Now we use the normal slabs and go in a C shape again. Redstone dust on top with an observer facing downwards from here into a magenta wool and two more on this side. Hook those up with redstone dust and one more redstone dust like this. We block off this connection again, and at the bottom we use an observer facing this way, two more slabs into a block, into a hopper with a slab on top, and redstone dust all across except of the observer. There we use a regular repeater on 4 ticks. This side is basically done already. I forgot to do something on the other side. We need 2 more pink wool on this side hooked up with redstone, and we should be done now. Now we can try if it all works. It's kind of a scary part. We have to delete the obsidian block again. And let's see. Perfect. And the retraction. Excellent. So all that is left is basically the corners now, as you saw, and which is the last circuit that we need. And it is kind of large. It's actually not that large, but we have to like kind of snake around everything else. Yeah, let's do that now. Okay, I actually forgot to do one more thing, which is really important, otherwise everything will break.
Everything will break.
We have to place 3 more observers here, here and here. Another one like this, and one more right here. We use 2 rails here and here. And now we can place the last observer. And for the last circuit, we use hopper again. One right here. It doesn't matter which way it's facing. An observer on the front, another hopper, another observer into a block, with another hopper below, another observer facing this way, with an orange wool at the bottom, a repeater on top on 4 ticks, a dropper right here, and an observer facing downwards. Another observer facing downwards on this side with a block below, with an observer diagonal next to it and an orange wool below again. A repeater on 4 ticks on this side, 2 sticky pistons right here, an observer facing upwards again with another sticky piston on the front, 2 normal pistons on this side and 2 on this side. Now we use an observer facing this way and one downwards. We need to get the connection up to this face now, meaning we go over like this, 2 up, and kinda snake our way inside right here. Now we place 2 slime blocks here and here. We can cover everything up except of this corner. We need a sticky piston on this side. And now I'm gonna copy it over to the other side, and then we'll see if it all works. And now it's time to do one of the most dangerous things you can do after finishing a contraption. Try if it works, and it has a flying machine in it, and I probably will break it. Let's see. Okay, the closing is all fine, and the opening. The corners are quite scary. Okay, that was all pretty perfect, and it worked. Also, make sure to remove the obsidian if you want to try and start it. In case your door doesn't close like this, and more looks like this. You see the corners down there? That's an issue, but we can fix that pretty easy. All we have to do is place observers here, here, and here. A sticky piston and a wall piece right here. We do the same on the other side, just like so. It will increase the size of the door slightly, but that's barely anything we can do against that. It really depends on the update order of the pistons, and now we should see the door is fixed. Everything else that you saw in the showcase is either decoration or slightly unnecessary. For example, I placed wood block right here and shulker boxes everywhere. It's basically to make sure I can see where the corner of each circuit is, and to make it visually more appealing. But other than that, you can't just leave it like that, build it into like a big bank, or I don't know what you need this kind of bank world for. But yeah, that's basically the tutorial. If you liked it, leave a like, check out the Discord server linked in the bottom below, subscribe to see more of this stuff, and I guess I can see you in the next video, and ciao!
Oh, garbage.
Test.